Good morning, children. Today we will continue from page 121. Okay, so we had learnt till now that Keshav and Shyama are siblings, means they are brothers and sisters, and near the cornice, means at the roof of the window, a bird have made a nest and the bird have laid the eggs in it. Now Keshav and Shyama do not have much knowledge about it. Okay, so many of the questions are erupting in their mind. All right, so now we will continue. This thought left the siblings very anxious. They decided to scatter some grain on the cornice for the bird to pick. Shyama said happily, "Oh, then the parent bird will not have to fly anywhere in search of food, will she?" "Oh no," said Keshav. "Why would she?" Okay, so they are now worried about the mother bird, that from where the mother bird will feed the small chicks. Okay, from where the mother bird will get the seeds. So what they are thinking? They are thinking that they will sprinkle or they will scatter some grains on the cornice for the bird to pick. And so the parent birds will not have to fly anywhere in search of the food, and the baby chicks will get the food, right? But this is not good, all right? The parent bird should go in search of the food. "But won't the chicks be uncomfortable up there?" asked Shyama anxiously. Keshav had not thought of this problem until then. "Yes," he said. "They are probably dying of thirst up there. There is no shade above them." Okay. So what they are thinking? Ki, they don't have the shade. All right. Means above the nest, there is no shade. So the chicks will feel uncomfortable. They are thinking as a human being. Okay. We as a human being feel uncomfortable without the shade. And we will feel thirsty and we will feel the warmth of the sun. But birds do not feel all these things. But these children are not aware of all these things. So they are thinking that way, ki the baby chicks will feel uncomfortable, right? So what they decided final, ki they will die of the thirst, and because there is no shade above them, it was finally decided that a makeshift roof would be erected. The children set to work above the nest. The proposal for a bowl of water and some rice was also welcomed with great enthusiasm. So what they decided, Keshav and Shyama, they decided to make a roof above the nest, okay, so that the baby cheeks do not feel uncomfortable. So they set to work above the nest. Then they also thought of putting the bowl of water and some rice also in a bowl, okay, and to keep it near the nest. The brother and sister began to work in earnest. Shyama quietly brought some rice from the clay pot. Keshav secretly emptied the stone bowl of its oil, scrubbed it clean and refilled it with water. Okay, so they set to work. Sister brought the rice, okay, secretly from the kitchen, and Keshav brought a bowl of oil, washed it clean and refilled it with water. So rice and water was ready. But where to get the cloth for the overhead hangings and how to make the roof? So now roof, the question of the roof is left. Okay. Keshav thought the problem for a while before it was finally resolved. "Go and get the waste paper basket. Make sure Ma doesn't see you." Okay. So what they were thinking and thinking, and Keshav got an idea and he told to Shyama to go and get the waste paper basket. And he also instructed that see that Ma doesn't know about it. But it's got a hole in the middle. How will it protect the birds from the sun? So what is Shyama telling? That it has got hole in the middle. Okay, so from that hole, the sun rays will come. So it will not protect the baby cheeks. First, you go and bring the basket, Keshav said with irritation. I'll take care of the hole. So what is Keshav telling? That you go and get it, we'll see about the hole. Shyama went running and returned with the basket. Keshav stuffed the hole with some paper. He then rested the basket against the branch of a nearby tree. See, how can the sun now shine upon the nest? Shyama thought admiringly. How clever my brother is. Okay, so that hole was closed by stuffing the paper into it. Okay, and Keshav got one branch of the tree. And so against that branch of the tree, the support of that, the paper basket was kept. Okay, and this way the shade was made. So Shyama thought admiringly and he thought that how clever his brother is. It was summer season. Babuji had gone to work. Having put both children to sleep, Ma was resting. The children, however, were nowhere near sleeping. Eyes shut with bated breath, they waited for the opportune moment. As soon as they were sure Ma was asleep, they got up quietly, unlatched the door and crept out. Soon they were making preparations to protect the eggs. Okay, so it was summer season. Babuji had gone to work. Having put both the children to sleep, Ma was also resting. Okay, so Ma thought that both the children will go to sleep and she also started resting. But the children had something different else in their mind. Okay, so they were waiting for the Ma to get to sleep so that they come out, okay, and do the needs for the nest. All right, so when Ma was asleep, they quietly came out of the room, unlatched the door, and they were soon making the preparations to protect the eggs. Keshav brought a stool from the room, but it did not help him to reach the cornice. Okay, so he then brought a small footrest from the bathroom to be placed under the first and gingerly climbed on top. Okay, so Keshav bought one stool, but on the stool also he was not able to reach the cornice. Alright, so he also brought the footrest from the bathroom and that was placed, and above that the stool was placed. You can see it in the picture, and then Keshav climbed. Shyama held the stool firmly with both hands as its legs were uneven. It was rather wobbly and it tipped slightly. Okay, so on this the preparation was made and Keshav climbed on the roof. You can see it in the picture. It is there, and Shyama was holding, okay, because Keshav was disbalancing the stool, and so Shyama was holding it firmly, alright, so that Keshav can do the rest of the preparation and rest of the thing above the nest. You can see it in the picture how they are keeping the roof and how they have kept the bowl of water and bowl of rice. Whichever way the weight increased, only Keshav knew what difficulty faced him at that moment. He would grab the cornice to steady himself and scold Shyama in a hushed voice, "Steadily or I'll come down and beat you properly." But poor Shyama's attention was distracted by the cornice. Time and again her mind wandered in that direction and her hold on the stool slackened. Okay, so Keshav was disbalancing on the stool. He was facing difficulty, and so he grabbed the cornice to make himself steady. Okay, matlab wo gir nahi jaye. Isiliye wo ekdam jor se usne cornice ko pakad liya. And he was scolding Shyama. Okay, ke you hold it steadily or I'll come down and beat you. But poor Shyama's attention was distracted. Okay, she also wanted to see the nest. Alright, and so her attention was distracted. As soon as Keshav's hands reached the cornice, the parent bird took flight. Keshav saw some twigs scattered on the cornice and three eggs lying on them. There was no nest like the ones he had seen on trees. Shyama asked curiously, "Can you see any cheeks, Bhaiya?" So as soon as Keshav's hand reached the cornice, parent birds flew away. All right. So Keshav saw some twigs scattered on the cornice and three eggs lying on them. So there was no proper nest, which they had seen it on the trees. Okay. So Shyama was asking curiously, "Can you see any cheeks, Bhaiya? There are three eggs. They haven't hatched yet. Please let me have a look at them, Bhaiya. How big are they?" So what is Bhaiya telling? What is Keshav telling? Ki there are three eggs and they haven't hatched yet. So Shyama also wanted to see the eggs. So she is telling that, "Please let me also have the look at them, Bhaiya. How big are they?" All right. So till here only we will do today. Okay. Other part of the chapter we will do in the next video. All right.